Well, I am back, and I am back with teeth. My last video was literally months ago. I also apologize if I'm staring at myself a lot. I'm filming off an iPhone. So last time I posted on here months ago, literally stuck toothless. No one in the medical realm anywhere knew what was going on in terms of chronic pain, organs collapsing, losing my teeth at a young age. I finally have answers and I have teeth. So I thought it's time for an update. If y'all follow me on TikTok, you would have seen my entire journey and followed the whole story along. Literally only got medical help thanks to TikTok. Took a year of pleading and begging doctors to take my chronic pain seriously, because when I had no teeth, doctors would look at me like I was nothing, essentially. I wasn't being taken seriously. But then the media caught wind of my story, and which is how I did the Truly interview and other interviews with news outlets and whatnot. And my goal with that was just in hopes a doctor would hear my story, see my situation, and be able to at least give me the time of day. Up until this point, I couldn't even get a GP because I was being told my health history is too complex, that they don't have time for me, blah, blah, blah. And at this point, my specialist halted all dental work in the fear of something underlying contributing to my tooth loss, and they were right. I'm not gonna get into the full story of how I got diagnosed, how I got teeth and all of that, but I wanna share the condition that has caused me to have dentures at a young age. I didn't even know this was a thing. So back in June of 2023, a doctor within the Ehlers-Danlos Society reached out to me after hearing my story in the news. My story, I was just pleading if any doctor is willing to just listen and read this letter and take me seriously. I just need damn teeth. That's all my, I just wanted teeth. It took like a year and a bit to get a doctor to listen, but a doctor within the Ehlers-Danlos Society saw my TikToks and saw my story and thought something was a little suspicious. She ended up meeting with me. She was a little suspicious of what type of EDS I have because of how fast I lost my teeth. I was told, and I was under the belief, my teeth began to literally crumble and break out of my mouth so fast, because after I had a minor car accident, I was prescribed naproxen, and naproxen gave me stomach ulcers. When I was vomiting from stomach ulcers, I would brush my teeth right away after. The dentist and the doctors told me brushing my teeth directly after vomiting is what caused my tooth loss. Then my dental specialists were like, that's a little fast. Like, you could literally pull my gums down to the root of my teeth. Like, it was so bizarre the way my teeth were just falling out. They were becoming loose, essentially. Like, it was almost like having baby teeth, but they were adult teeth. So she was suspicious because of that and my family history. My family history, like, bad teeth run on my dad's side like freaking wildfire. At a really young age, my dad always told me, brush your teeth properly, you're gonna have dentures by the time you're 30, all my sisters have them, blah, blah, blah. My dad literally used to check the inside of my mouth every night before bed because of how bad teeth are in my family. I always had like good oral hygiene, hence why I was brushing like a freaking madman after vomiting, which you're not supposed to do regardless, even though it's not directly what caused my tooth loss. You're not supposed to brush after you freaking vomit. Give it 30 minutes, swish with water to get out the taste, but don't do it directly after. That just sped it up. So given my family history, all of that, certain things not aligning with the diagnostic criteria for hypermobile EDS, the doctor in the EDS society decided to refer me for genetics testing. And in Canada, genetics testing through the government, I guess it would be, it's priority based. So I was told last summer it could take 2 years to get this done. Because once they send my referral and records off to genetics then basically prioritizes who gets in first. Once they, you know, choose your case, I guess, then they have to see if it'll get funded through MSP. Basically, if the medical services plan of BC sees it as just to pay for it, essentially. She told me to anticipate to pay about like $200 to have the states do this because of how long Canada can take. She has patients still waiting, and it's almost been 2 years for them. So I had that in mind, and then come October, I got a call from genetics. They got my referral and they want to meet with me. That was really fast. Even the EDS doctor was like, they must have seen something to get you in that fast. So that was a little scary, but happy nonetheless. So I had to fill out a ton of forms, health questionnaires about my family, about myself. They had to get all my records. By November, I got the news that MSP approved it. So, meaning it's covered. Completely free for me to do this genetics testing, which is amazing because it is expensive otherwise. November, I signed the consent forms. By January, my blood was being sent to Finland. So I've also been saying I've gone to Finland now because my blood technically has been there. Anyway, my blood went to Finland in January. Mid-February, genetics calls. They got the results back. There's nothing major. The doctor in genetics wants to see me and have a chat. And so I'm like, okay, I'm still scared, but good, nothing major showed up. By the time he had availability, it was March 12th. The March 12th that just passed, March 12th, 2024. I'm like jam packing a shit ton of stuff that's happened in a few months into a short video. So if you wanna see the lengthier version of how this all played out, it's all on my TikTok at Nat's Denture Adventure. So March 12th comes around, it's time to meet with genetics. We have to go to the BC Women's and Children's Hospital. That's where the genetics center is. First of all, that section of the hospital, it felt like we should not have been there. There was hallways with doors that just said like genetic evaluations, like genetic results, gene mutation, like it was intense. There was no one else down there aside from medical staff, and like they looked like kind of shocked to see anyone down there. You see this in this room, and it's like a conference room mixed with an exam room. It's like this big round table with a bunch of chairs on it, my big ass medical file, I guess, that they have made, a big ass binder of mine, sitting in the middle of the desk. But then surrounding us is like all the medical stuff, like an exam table, a sink, and like a measuring tape stuff, like all of that stuff. So it was really freaking weird. I'll insert a clip of what I took from there. So the doctor comes in and he was a very interesting man. I don't think I will ever meet another doctor like him. He was amazing, but very interesting man. I was there for about an hour and a half, and we were talking about the diagnostic criteria of this type of EDS. And this type of EDS is the one the Eller Downloads doctor suspected. It's the rarest form of EDS. It's like less than 200 people to date diagnosed with it, although it is like supposedly an underdiagnosed condition, so there's likely way more than 200 out there, which is why genetics got me in so fast. They send like a whole ass video to mentally prepare you for this beforehand, but they do a panel of 300 different genes. There's three different answers that can come back: positive, negative, or uncertain. The genes for PEDS for mine came back uncertain. The doctor's like, there's many different reasons why it could show uncertain. And even things that show negative on some people's genetics panels aren't accurate. It's still not foolproof. We have to keep that in mind. But with that being uncertain, he then had to go through all the records to date that have been done of PEDS, because it's still very little known. He had to go through all those studies, their diagnostic criteria, all of that, compare it to mine and my family history. He is 99.9% confident and certain I do have periodontal Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. It's a very rare form of EDS. If you don't know, periodontal basically means tooth related stuff. I'll put in the term right there. This news, it didn't come as a huge shock, to be quite honest, because of my dad's childhood warnings, but also my mom was born with one kidney and two uteruses, and her dad had a hole in his heart. So I know rare medical shit isn't uncommon in my family. When I found out this news, I was excited but also confused because it like completely depleted everything I believed for years. Like I always thought vomiting and brushing after is what caused my tooth loss, and no, it just sped it up by about 2-3 years, he figures. What happens when you have periodontal Ehlers Danlos syndrome is it starts really young. You get basically, it's almost like periodontal, well it is periodontal disease at a really young age, which affects your gums. Your gums are constantly inflamed and it affects how your teeth grow and develop. My gums, I used to like kind of refer to them as stretchy or like gapped gums. Because I could either pull my gum all the way down to see like the root of my tooth, or it would be gapped like it on its own. Like I would open my mouth and like a part of my gum like near my molar would be gapped to the point I could see down to the root. So with people who have PEDS, periodontal Ehlers Danlos syndrome, that is one of the main things is there's a technical term for it, a medical term for it. It's not stretchy gums. Essentially why my teeth have always sucked since childhood, even my baby teeth were breaking on freaking bread and marshmallows, and like they took forever to grow back in, some didn't want to come out, like it explains so much. But anyway, basically what happens is when your gums are like that, food is getting down and stuck in and underneath your teeth and in your roots. You can't get the toothbrush to. It gets in there, it causes a cavity, and it starts to decay your teeth. I was going to lose my teeth regardless. Which, and honestly, like this news would have been a lot harder if I had teeth still. Like imagine if I had my natural teeth and they were like, so you're about to lose your teeth, that would be a fucking gut punch. But I've already through the brunt of it. But let's talk about the worst parts that come with PEDS, because this is actually like a serious condition. Aside from the oral manifestations, the brain disease is a big one that comes with periodontal Ehlers Danlos syndrome. You have periodontal Ehlers Danlos syndrome, you've had periodontal disease since childhood, you're more susceptible to developing brain disease, and it's a matter of white tissue in the brain, like too much white matter. Less than 5% of people who have PEDS have heart issues. We are starting all the testing for that. There's 50% chance my kids, should I have children one day, will inherit this. And to me, that's probably the worst news. Just knowing like, if I have kids, I might be putting another little human being through the shit I went through. It explains also all my joint issues since a kid. This explains my prolapses, my everything issues. I've only known this news for like 2.5-3 weeks. So this is all really new. And I avoided doing any update before then because I didn't have a solid answer. There was still things not making sense. And so my updates were just kind of like, my updates on TikTok, I just repeat what I'm being told from the doctor. Naively, it's been hell and back getting this diagnosis. I'm just so bloody grateful that it's freaking confirmed, set in stone from a doctor in genetics. Like this isn't no clinic doctor being like, you have this. This is like a set in stone diagnosis. All these years, my dental specialist never knew if I'd be able to get implants because of my jaw issues. And then the idea of implants were on the table to hold my denture better in place. Now with this news, absolutely not. Nope, can't have implants. So that kind of sucks, but also saving some money there. So it's like, it could be worse. I think that's the main gist. I just wanted to come on here because like I've done interviews with a lot of different companies, media outlets. I was sharing my story of what I believed and thought I knew, that I lost my teeth from brushing them after vomiting, and that's just not the case. So I just want to come on here and let y'all know why I lost my teeth. Now going forward, I still have my temporary dentures. I got these in August. Once I found out I had EDS, that gave me enough medical clearance to get teeth, but that's a whole other story. If y'all want to know the story of getting teeth again and all of that, I can do that. So that's the update, and maybe I'll be back soon, or maybe it'll be months again, who knows. But have a great weekend and I'll see you guys later.